Oh, Darrell, this is so good. As Todd was speaking, pop up that question, Darrell, from George Henderson, because I think it's just going to trigger a great conversation.
Yeah, George says, Todd, when you started digging into your research, what traits or attributes did you find that led to these kind of buyer results? It seems somewhat counterintuitive. That came earlier in the conversation. We were talking about some of that research about negative reviews helping establish trust.
Yeah, I mean, if you really think about it, I'm going to give you a couple of examples. Imagine, so there's a company, it's our favorite retailer in the world. I'm sure it's your favorite retailer in the world. It's IKEA, right? Like everybody, no? Oh, you hate it? Right, of course you hate it. IKEA is a freaking nightmare,
Right.
right? 13, when you think about going into a retailer and they have to give you a map, but you know you're in for it, right? And then you have to go through these curvy walkways to find what you're looking for. You finally find it, no salesperson around to help you out. So what do? Well, you have to take a picture of the tag with your phone or write down the code because you get to go to the warehouse yourself, pick 150-pound boxes off of shelves onto carts that don't have brakes, which seems like an unbelievable oversight. Like just put a little brake in the thing. Then you check out, you go into the parking lot. If you're ever looking for something fun to do on a Saturday afternoon, just go sit out there and count the F1s of newly married couples that are like jamming boxes into the back of their hatchback and like swearing at each other. You get done, you start driving home, and you're
The
like,
fun's just beginning.
yeah, exactly right. You think you just left the fun back at the store,
Right.
but you've got a nice souvenir injury or two as a to remember it all. You get home, you open the box, and there's 150 parts. And the only words on the work instructions are things like Svarta or whatever they And so
So true.
you F-bomb your way through that. And then at the end, you're like, you know what? We should have gotten the end tables with this bedroom furniture. Let's go back.
Let's go back.
The point being that for 13 straight years, IKEA is the number one furniture retailer in the world, right? In the world. And it's a nightmare. Now, why? How? Well, it's companies like IKEA that have branded their negatives. I think there's an opportunity in the B2B world for us to think about that. But it's, hey, listen, we're going to give up certain elements of the experience so that we can give you modern Scandinavian design furniture you didn't pay much for. Oh, there's meatballs upstairs if you want those too.
Right.
But the
They're
point
pretty
being
good.
that they're really good. And the sweet rolls are fantastic. But the point being, if I walk into an IKEA and I'm like, I would like a sales professional to feng shui my living room, and then I want this design. They'd be like, cool, there's a room and board down the street. Macy's got great furniture. Like, go there, right? Embrace the things you give up to be great at your core.